Approximately 3 weeks pre-calving, they move from the sanctuary just literally through the gate into this area over the schoolyard behind us. Because it's literally an adjacent yard, it minimises the stress of the move. That's important that we have as little stress as possible pre-calving. I think this is quite a grand device at the far off the next level gate. Close to calving, close to here, and those are the so this building here is used for the close-up cows, the main bedding area where we're targeting sort of 10 stroke 11 square metres of cows. The close-up is a flying area. This means that 24-25 cows in the year rarely end up with a line space is very important for this group, because obviously this is a socially unstable group, starving, if there's need for any intervention, there's a secure headlock there, so there's only one person around that can safely and securely contain a cow for starving. That's important for the less stress on the cow, but also for the safety of the operator. And then once it's tired, the cow can start moving into one of the individual pens here. Good water supply from the pen, so it's possible to get water into the tubs, so they've got clean water. And then they're also given probably all year round, 3 times a day milk, supplying the local liquid dairy. The milkers are all by the very fresh food on cubicles. The dry cows are all the schoolyard system that we've got here behind us. So this building houses all the dry cows, both of the starving group and the fresh cow group. And basically, they move in at one end. The large group here behind us is far off. They then literally move through a gate, central section of the shed, for 2 days, as a close-up group, and then the staff will remove, and then the freshly carved animals are moved through the gate to the far end of the shed, which again is for 2 days, and that's where they're fed, the milk cow as a fresh cow group. This building works well for a number of reasons. One is that cows tend to move quite seamlessly through the building. So again, they're sharing the same airspace, the feed is in the same place, the water is in the same place. They're quite familiar with the surroundings, so even though there is a group check, generally around 2 weeks pre-calving, it tends to go very smoothly because they are literally just the other side of the gate where we were. Being an open-fronted shed, this shed is quite well naturally ventilated. It's got a cap to it. You can see it over here, which does encourage airflow through. However, in hot summer weather, what we want this advantage to do is stadium itself has been warm. It's more of an urban pitch. This building has been there every 3 weeks religiously. Daily, along with many buildings, there's always room for improvement. This one has been extended to give us a little bit more room to ensure that overstocking is never an issue. It would be good to have a foot traffic provision here. There's 5,000 foot traffic in the social transport through the Julian Parlour, going through the local foot traffic. Due any day, we can do the carving gate, which again will allow thousands to be safe and easily spread for any work that is needed on the carving way to assist with the carving or the administration of the council road to the carving. So again, that will just ensure safety, minimal stress on the time, and allow here we are in the fresh cow section of the shed where there are 32 sand bedding cubes installed. The rest of the units are all on mattresses and sawdust, but the decision was taken from the point of view of maximising cow comfort, hygiene, grip, etc. And those specifically for this fresh cow bed. So cows staying here for typically 5 days to 2 weeks. They move on into the cow or heifer booth once they've been moved on to the main of the booth. The prevailing weather comes along to this side of the building, so both the close-up booth we saw earlier and the fresh cow area has got a temperature-controlled automatic curtain system which controls the ventilation and the airflow into the shed. So currently it's wide open. You can see it's getting a high level of light and fresh air. If it rains or the temperature drops, that curtain automatically lifts and therefore reduces the weather coming into the building.